YouTubers who ended their careers in seconds. YouTube has long since allowed countless content creators to achieve fame and fortune from the comfort of their own homes with nothing more than a camera and a dream. And yes, they make a ton of money and amass a huge fan base simply by recording yourself playing video games, doing tutorials, taking a video of your dog playing tricks, and so much more. But many other YouTube stars haven't been so lucky. In fact, their luck somehow ended. Sometimes YouTubers step out of line or make a dumb mistake. People will then unsubscribe in droves, effectively canceling their channel. Who are they? We'll find more about them in the video. So relax and grab some snacks. Anyway, don't forget to subscribe to Starface Productions and hit the bell icon for more updates at the comfort of your homes. Hit the thumbs up button as well. It won't hurt. These are YouTubers who ended their careers in seconds. Number 8. Logan Paul. Again, it's Logan Paul. Someone give the guy an award for notoriety. Logan Paul was born on April 1, 1995. He's an American actor, director, internet personality, screenwriter, rapper, and white-collar boxer. Paul first gained fame through videos shared on former internet video service, Vine. Paul's television and film work includes guest appearances on Law & Order, Special Victims Unit, Weird Loners, and starring roles in other films. Logan Paul kicked off 2018 by uploading a video of him touring Aokigahara, a forest in Japan known for its high rate of suicides. In the now-deleted video, Paul allegedly filmed the body of a person who hanged themselves in the forest, calling out to the body and describing its lifeless appearance. Wow, just one post! Paul eventually took to Twitter to apologize, writing, "I didn't do it for views. I did it because I thought I could make a positive ripple on the internet." He then posted a video apology saying he never should have posted the video and asked his fans not to defend his actions. How is insensitively filming a dead man positive, Logan? According to the New York Times, YouTube has canceled its business relationship with Paul in the wake of the scandal. Good job, YouTube. Number 7. Jared Nebenbauer. Also known as Pro Jared, he's a YouTuber that is only focused on game videos. He's most known for his reviews on Nuzlocke series, as well as his work at his former employer, ScrewAttack. He lost thousands of subscribers in 2019 after his wife accused him of infidelity. According to his wife, Heidi O'Farrell, Nebenbauer had an affair with fellow YouTube gamer, Holly Conrad. She even tweeted about it, saying, "I have proof, explicit conversations and photographs of their relationship, which he extensively lied to me about on many occasions. He was promising me that he was committed to our relationship at the time, and promising her he was breaking up with me." Nebenbauer hit a million subs in 2018, but after O'Farrell publicly trashed him on Twitter, the gamer lost over 100,000 subs in a single day, which is a tenth of his following. O'Farrell said that she spilled the beans after she realized her husband had blocked her and made a statement on their impending split without first consulting her. Prompted by his wife's claims, some fans came forward claiming he'd solicit nude photos with them. Nebenbauer admitted that he exchanged photos with consenting adults on occasion and apologized. "What I was doing was not predatory, but it was unhealthy," he said. He's been dropped from his agency, and many in the gaming community had since distanced themselves from him. Number 6. Zoella. We all know Zoella, who was featured in some PewDiePie and Marja's video. For those of you who don't know her, Zoe Elizabeth Sugg is an English vlogger, businesswoman, and author. She first started uploading videos to YouTube in 2009. Each video lasts between 10 to 20 minutes and sees the pretty brunette talk to the camera about everything from lipstick to anxiety, pets, and beyond. She holds a great deal of influence on social media too, but it was YouTube that saw millions of fans flock to her content. Currently, she has a staggering 11.2 million subscribers. Her downfall started when she was accused of being flippant about domestic violence, after revealing that her favorite game is shouting "help" out the window to make neighbors think her boyfriend is attacking her. And also, she came under fire for a series of tweets about pregnancy, as she suggested she would troll people if she were to fall pregnant. She immediately deleted the video and addressed public apologies, but it's too late for apologies. Fans were also disappointed with the release of her debut book, Girl Online, as it transpired that she was helped by ghostwriters. Number 5. Sam Pepper. Sam Pepper is a British personality, video blogger, comedian, and prankster. He created his YouTube channel in 2010 and holds over 2 million subscribers and 70 million video views as of February 2017. His downfall started when Sam Pepper was accused of sexual allegations by many women after the fake hand-ass pinch prank video published in 2014. You should have known better than that. And who could forget the killing best friend prank video published in 2015? This kind of action led to people ostracizing Pepper, and there ended his YouTube career. Number 4. SourceFed. Fed up with these YouTubers? Too bad, cause we're not yet done. SourceFed is a YouTube channel created by Philip DeFranco in January 2012 as part of YouTube's $100 million original channel initiative, and was originally produced by James Hafner. The channel was popular owing to its special feature that involved the interaction of featured people. As a result, the people loved SourceFed, which enjoyed 1.8 million subscribers. The channel has mainly focused on popular culture, news and technology, and people of the content. Not everything was smooth sailing though. The channel began to fall in rating due to the channel transforming and being sold to now this. This brand started working differently and posted its videos, which diminished the charm of SourceFed. Number 3. Rovana. Yovana Mendoza, also known as Rovana, is a YouTuber and a blogger. She began her health and wellness journey back in 2013 when she found a new way of living and enjoying life, substance-free and sober. Rovana became a certified holistic health coach at the Institute of Integrative Nutrition to help others through their health journey and transformation. She is committed to helping them achieve the best version of themselves to lead a healthier lifestyle, to lean into change and challenges, to get out of their comfort zone, and let growth take place inside them. Fun fact, she proclaimed herself to be vegan. So what went wrong? Well, she accidentally appeared with fish on her plate in a fellow YouTuber's social media live feed. What were the odds? After the incident, Rovana made a public address about the issue that only caused her fans to grow angrier with her. Some accused of deceiving them, while others accused her of downright animal cruelty for eating animal products again. When you're known for blogging about vegan food and lifestyle choices, one of the worst crimes you can commit is going against your word. Number 2. John Jafari. His downfall started when he decided to show his support for Steve King, a US representative from Iowa. To connect the dots, King stoked controversy when he tweeted support for far-right Dutch politician Geert Wilders. Jafari is of Hungarian and Iranian heritage, yet he went all out for King in his own tweet. "Wow, how scandalous," he said. "Steve King doesn't want his country invaded by people who have contempt for his culture and people. Nazi." The YouTuber doubled down in a live stream, revealing what Polygon described as wide-ranging right-wing sympathies that appeared to have blindsided many of his viewers, some of whom have withdrawn their YouTube subscriptions. Jafari dropped 10,000 subscribers in the immediate aftermath, and while he's managed to keep his YouTube channel afloat, his claims about wealthy blacks in the United States committing more crimes than poor whites have all but guaranteed that a career in the mainstream is no longer a possibility for this gamer and comedian. Number 1. Austin Jones. If you haven't heard of him, Austin Jones is a former American musician who started as a YouTuber in 2007. He had around 540,000 subscribers and over 20 million video views. That's a lot of power, but it came crashing down real quick. In 2017, the 26-year-old who was known for his a cappella pop song covers was sentenced to 10 years in prison after he admitted to persuading underage girls to send him sexually explicit videos of themselves. Ew, such a disgusting guy. Court documents obtained by The Verge confirmed that Jones asked over 30 girls to prove that they were real fans by getting naked or performing sexually explicit acts. At first, it looked as though YouTube wasn't going to act. But a few days after Jones' guilty plea, his channel was terminated. And that's the end of our segment. Some YouTubers managed to bring their canceled channels back from the dead, but that black mark will always be on their permanent record, like a hot sauce stain on your favorite ugly sweater. Anyway, let us know in the comments below if we forgot to mention someone. By the way, Don't forget to subscribe to Starface Productions and hit the bell icon for more updates. The thumbs up button as well, guys. Thank you.